Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining me today for the latest in developer tooling for Microsoft Edge. My name is Erica Droud, and I'm a program manager for Microsoft Edge Developer Tools. We have so many improvements and features that we've added since last time, but we only have a few minutes, so I'm going to highlight some new tooling, and we have a gist linked that gives you access to everything that you've heard here that's out, and anything that we might have missed that we didn't have time to fit in. We'll start with a brief overview before diving into updates and demos in the testing and automation segment, as well as accessibility and the collaborative space. Let's start with a bit of context to summarize a few changes since last Ignite. The new Microsoft Edge launched on January 15, 2020. In July, the new Edge installed on hundreds of millions of devices worldwide. And we've also had 850, well, more than 850 DevTools Chromium commits since then. We've expanded our reach into VS Code too, with extensions for the Elements and Debugger Edge developer tools, as well as the WebHint open source tool, and there'll be even more that we'll get into more detail with later. The work we'll be discussing revolves around consistent and cross-platform tools for browser and web applications, empowering and including more developers via accessibility and localization, productive experiences across tools and services, and continuing to add value by uncovering and solving your problems. First, let's address the tooling area where problems are really discovered, testing and automation. You can test your web application for customers on different browsers and devices, and you can automate things like scraping the web for data and more. We want to help you have a smoother CI/CD pipeline and release management process. We've made investments in browser testing and automation, making sure that you can easily reuse your previous tests for Edge, regardless of what browser they were for. We've enabled support for Selenium, WebDriver, Puppeteer, Playwright, and CI/CD via Docker containers. Make sure to look out for Edge on Linux, which will be available very soon. Next, let's check out a new tool called Playwright to drive Edge. We know from our customer research and feedback that cross-browser testing is still a major pain point for web developers. Puppeteer used to be just for automating Chromium, but now we're able to automate further by simulating multiple browsers. I'd like to introduce you to Playwright, a cross-browser automation library that enables you to run tests in Chromium-based browsers like Microsoft Edge, the WebKit-based Safari browser from Apple, and the Gecko-based Mozilla Firefox. In this demo, we're using Jest as our test runner and Playwright to automate Microsoft Edge dev. To start, we'll be serving our web app on localhost 4200. From there, we have an NPM script that calls Jest our test runner. Now let's take a look at the test itself. You'll see that we're requiring Chromium from Playwright. To get Playwright to run Edge, we're also providing the path to msedge.exe. In this demo, we're choosing to automate the Microsoft Edge Dev Preview channel. Normally, we'd be running in headless mode, but for this demo, we wanted to show the browser launching and loading the page. We'll run the test now and see Playwright launch Edge successfully, navigate to localhost 4200, and run our tests. You'll see that both of the tests in our test suite pass. In this demo, we're just running our tests in Microsoft Edge Dev, but with just a few more lines, we could just as easily run this test in WebKit to test Safari and Gecko to test Firefox. We hope you check out the Playwright repo on GitHub or add it to your project from NPM today. Context switching is a major developer pain point, right? We made the browser something to use on a code level and run it from your IDE. Why not have the dev tools in the same context? Here I'm showing the elements for Edge in VS Code, which was our first developer tool we integrated. We followed this with the debugger for Edge, and soon we'll have the full suite. Inclusion is very important to us here at Microsoft. We as a team believe that our tools should be available and accessible to everyone. We've been committed to filling those gaps in web development. Of the over 850 commits we mentioned, more than 200 of them were to make the Chromium DevTools more accessible to every web developer. We need to ensure that the needs of every customer is heard, and that's why we love hearing your feedback. So this space has sort of become my domain in the developer tool space, and it's been really awesome seeing the initiative on the doc side to create this full locale experience. We wanted to amplify the DevTools by making a fully localizable debugging experience. You can see here on the left, we have the DevTools documentation open in Japanese, and also the developer tools open in Japanese. And on the right side, we have VS Code with the Japanese language pack for an end-to-end localized experience. You can debug in the browser's developer tools, access localized versions of our documentation, then head to your localized VS Code in multiple languages. We want to make localized resources and tools more widespread, since we shouldn't expect all developers to be most comfortable debugging in English. A simple yet effective addition to the developer tools is high contrast mode. And in this case, I'm showing Wikipedia simulating high contrast mode without putting the developer tools or operating system in high contrast mode. Developers can test with folks that have low vision in mind. High contrast makes it easier for them to understand what's on the page, whether that's the browser or the developer tools. Elements on the page are framed to make them stand out and words stand out more clearly. More importantly, this means you don't have to put your operating system into high contrast mode. You can work the way you're used to, and you can see what your product would look like in a high contrast environment. If you want your developer tools or your operating system in high contrast mode, you can do that too. But this is especially interesting for Mac users who don't have the same high contrast mode that Windows does. Source Order Viewer was initially raised as a suggestion through the Web We Want series that we have. This highlighted the need to understand how page content will appear to screen readers. It's cool how one person's submission is now being shipped so developers can more effectively visualize how assistive technologies will encounter their page. This is important to make sure screen reader users will be able to understand the content on the page in the right order. It's critical to a positive user experience for all. We're really happy to make tools like this available in the Chromium space because we want to remove this barrier from people's lives, which brings us to our next session. We believe that sharing tools with the open source community or with the Chromium community is critical to creating a better web that everyone can use effectively. Plus, it leads to some pretty interesting and exciting collaborations. First, we have WebHint. WebHint is a best practices tool that you can use in your browser to stay on top of accessibility, cross-browser compatibility, security, performance, PWA recommendations, and more while debugging. The screenshot provided demonstrates an example of a scan on a website and the hints provided to improve the site in many ways. Based on the NPM module of WebHint, the issues pane of the developer tools will display collapsible categories of issues as well as their proposed solutions. Together, hints and issues provides you with a helpful first pass of the web application you're debugging. You can also get these WebHint insights from the VS Code extension. There's also a CLI if you want a readout of the results when you NPM install WebHint to your machine. If you want to contribute to this open source project or just want to learn more, check out the gist that we have linked. It'll have all the links that you need. Issues is an Edge-specific tool, but WebHint is an open source project started by Microsoft that's now under the OpenJS Foundation. Here we have grid tooling, where you can have more information about the different grid elements on your web page with overlays and configuration options, such as deciding what you want in tooltips, changing colors of lines, etc. You can see the different elements with the grid adorner. This was an exciting collaboration with the Chrome team that's currently in the experimentation stage. Here we have movable tabs. This is for all the times that you wanted to adjust the different tool panes so that you'd have the smoothest debugging UI experience. Customize your DevTools to be as comprehensive or clean as you like. An experimental feature we have in the works enables you to match your keyboard shortcuts to presets. One of the default presets allows you to match the shortcuts you're used to in the VS Code. Or maybe you're like me. I'm one of those people who isn't super efficient and I don't bother to learn keyboard shortcuts aside from the classics like save with Control S, or copy and paste with Control C and Control V. But now you can make the keyboard shortcuts make sense to you and have the inputs that you feel are the most intuitive. All right, we made it. A few minutes of fun with your friendly DevTools PM, where we covered some big changes since last year. I hope you all enjoyed this journey through the Edge developer tools. We covered a lot, so make sure to check out our gist linked here and stay up to date on all things Edge DevTools by checking out our Twitter account. Feel free to send us feedback through the DevTools feedback icon. Our team personally reads each feedback item you send, and that helps us build the right thing and build it right. You can also contact me through Twitter or leave a comment below if you have any questions about the topics we covered today. Thanks so much.